Good evening. My name is Dr. I. Shivadipti, and my paper topic is study of craniocerebral trauma by computer tomography. Introduction: traumatic head injury results in a substantial number of deaths, permanent disabilities around the world. Traumatic brain injury is defined as an aggression to the brain caused by external physical force that may produce a state of diminished or altered consciousness and consequently affecting cognitive abilities or physical function. It may be temporary or permanent and may cause partial or total impairment of such functions. Traumatic brain injury can be classified based on location into intra and extraaxial. Primary lesions are the direct result of trauma to the head, and secondary lesions arise as complications of primary lesions. Clinically, this classification is important because secondary injuries can be preventable. Aims and objectives. The main aims and objectives of this study are to characterize the spectrum of primary craniocerebral injuries on CT and to associate the CT findings with the clinical status of patients using GCS as a reference standard. Coming to materials and methods, the study was conducted at the Department of Radiodiagnosis, Chandra Medical College and General Hospital, Nandyal, to characterize the spectrum of primary craniocerebral injuries on CT and to associate the CT findings with clinical status of patients using GCS as a reference standard. Source of data: the study, the subjects of this study are the participants of both sexes above 18 years of age, referred to the Department of Radiodiagnosis, Chandra Medical College and General Hospital, Nandyal, to undergo CT during the period from October 2020 to September 2021 for a period of 12 months, who satisfy the inclusion and exclusion criteria. Sampling criteria include inclusion criteria: all subjects with history of craniocerebral trauma undergoing CT within 24 hours of admission, and exclusion criteria include postoperative patients. Results and analysis. In this study, 100 patients with a history of craniocerebral trauma underwent CT scan following initial assessment by GCS score. Images were obtained in axial sections followed by multiplanar reconstruction. Images were evaluated to look for primary craniocerebral injuries and to associate CT findings with clinical status of patients using GCS as a reference standard. Table 1 shows a distribution of fractures. It is more common fractures are linear, accounting for 46%, followed by absent fracture 37%. Table 2 shows prevalence and association of cerebral edema with GCS score. Table 3 shows prevalence and association of midline shift with the GCS score. Table 4 shows distribution of extraaxial hemorrhages in total study population. EDH accounts for 35%, SDH accounts for 42%, and SAH accounts for 28%. This is the axial CT image showing a extradural hemorrhage along left frontal convexity. This is the axial CT image showing hyperdensity in the fissures, which represents a subarachnoid hemorrhage. Figure 3 represents an axial CT image showing hyperdensity along left frontotemporal convexity, which includes subdural hemorrhage. Figure 4 includes a bilateral frontal convexity intraparenchymal hemorrhage. Discussion: neuroradiology of head trauma has undergone many dramatic changes since the advent of CT, which has significantly helped to modify the management in cases of head trauma. A total of 100 subjects with history of craniocerebral trauma undergoing CT within 24 hours of admission were evaluated during 12-month period of this study. Based on the inclusion criteria, 100 patients were selected to be included in this study. This is a prospective study which included 100 patients who suspected to have head injury. After obtaining a brief clinical history and an initial neurological assessment, GCS, the patients were subjected to CT scan. CT examination was done on a high-speed dual CT image using both brain and bone algorithms, and imaging findings were then correlated with GCS of the patient. Conclusion: CT is a fast and accurate technique, initial imaging modality of choice in acute craniocerebral trauma, which allows rapid diagnosis of the majority of brain injury cases. Based on the observations made in this study, it was concluded that GCS within 24 hours of admission played a major role in quick and reliable assessment of neurological status of the patient. Primary craniocerebral injuries as seen on CT also correlated with the severity of head injury clinically assessed by GCS score as reference standard. Use of GCS score for assessing the level of injury clinically in combination with CT findings aids in deciding management of the patients. These are my references. Thank you.